The State University of New York was created as a result of the demand for higher educational access. The private universities and colleges had a limited set of facilities. They were selective in who could be admitted. And here you had suddenly a group of GIs, veterans, who came from all walks of life, rich and poor. New York had to build a brand new system. What was followed was a model which was quite different from the existing model of that period.
SUNY is unique in terms of its size. We're the largest public higher education. We have something for everyone. We have technical colleges, we have community colleges, we have university centers. And particularly at this time in the history of this nation, when there are some efforts to roll back this our commitment to equity and justice, that SUNY's got to stand out and say, this is why we were created, so that we can provide a place where people can come, no matter what their background, and get the kind of quality education that will prepare them for the leadership skills that we need at this time in society.
The one tried and true tactic in American history to deal with social mobility, economic mobility, dealing with wage inequality has been access to a quality higher education. And the nation's public universities have been themselves the engine of that.
Every university in the world must change with tremendous speed. The way they developed the students a decade ago will not have the skills that we need a decade from now. And you have to have the courage to make the change. So I think it's important that universities worldwide begin to prepare for the students of the future and to prepare them in terms of how they create the skills for the job and the constant relearning at a very rapid rate.
When the system decides that it wants to do something important, when it has an eye on equity, when it has an eye on innovation, when it has an eye on impact, it can do it at scale. So that not only transforms the life of an individual, it can transform the lives of many individuals in a community, and it can also have great impact on the nation and, in fact, the world.
The SUNY system is 1.3 million students across 64 different locations. That requires a different type of leadership. It requires coordination among the various functional groups, learning from each other, the ability to do innovation at a tremendous scale.
Christina has a track record where everywhere she goes, it gets better. She came to Duke, the Pratt School got much better. She went to Hopkins and did a sterling job leading them in a direction they needed to go as provost. She was the Undersecretary of Energy. She formed a series of companies in an area that this country desperately needs, which is clean energy.
I think one of the key hallmarks of a successful entrepreneur is being creative, finding solutions whenever you hit an obstacle. It's not an unusual challenge for an entrepreneur to have a big vision, but how you implement that and transform that vision into an action plan and into reality is what makes the difference between a dreamer and a successful entrepreneur.
The president wanted all of us to not only think about the way that we were going to make the country work better, and that we were going to help move the country back from the edge of this financial crisis. And she was able to bring all of that knowledge and all of that skill to the fore, thinking about innovation, thinking about ways to work with the business sector, ways to work with entrepreneurs, and interestingly, ways to work with academia so that we could get the best from all of those partners.
Why is an investment in research so important in the SUNY system? Engineering technology is increasingly important. I was particularly impressed with her background in science and engineering. We need to be outstanding, I think, in that area.
So I think the researchers and the faculty members really respect somebody who has done it before. And if you look at Chancellor Johnson, she really has, you know, singled out herself in terms of one of the best researchers in terms of creating a National Science Foundation Engineering Research Center. She's a member of the National Academy of Inventors. She is fellow of the IEEE. She is fellow of the American Association of Advancement of Science. So she has created the respect, and she has the sort of vision for solving major problems that the country is facing. What I like the most is really that she has played cricket. And there are very few people I know at the chancellor's position that have played cricket.
She set an example that I think was unique at Duke. And again, it's very simple. Go in the cafeteria, she's having coffee. She's surrounded by students. They want to engage, they want to talk to her, they want her knowledge, they want her experience, they want her support.
She made it known that what I want from you all is to hear about you and your story. She just wanted students to know that she is indeed the new chancellor in town, and she has a passion to make sure that every student experience is a great one throughout all SUNY schools.
I think that universities, community colleges, have such an important role to play in creating more sustainable communities, a more sustainable economy. And I know that Christina has every skill set and the track record to be able to do that and to ensure the SUNY system is able to do that.
So when I think of Christina, I think of passion. She cares. And it's not just in the academic world, she cares about people.
She's an inclusive leader. I'd bet on her all day long, and I'd back any organization that she was involved in.
She is always prepared. She does not waste time, and she really gets to the heart of the matter and does it in a very, obviously a very pleasant way, but an efficient way, demonstrating real leadership as she does it. We all struggle to keep up with her.
She's just the right person we need at this particular time.